Hi, my name's Josh Pierce. I'm a graffiti abatement officer with the City of Fort Collins Streets Department. My job is to remove graffiti around the city. Unfortunately, graffiti happens more than we'd like it to, and there are multiple ways to actually report the graffiti to us, which we are so thankful for. Every time we get a request for graffiti, we always dispatch a person to come and evaluate it. It can be as simple as just taking a wipe and removing it from an electrical box that's city owned, that has been coated and treated, and we can easily take that off. Some of the more challenging surfaces are brick and concrete, and oftentimes we'll evaluate that. If we cannot remove it with any chemicals, many times we'll often have to resort to pressure washing or painting over the surface. And we do our best to always match the color of that surface. One of the things that catches our attention most is any hateful speech or offensive language, and immediately we will remove any of those tags. It's important that graffiti is removed as quickly as possible. It lowers the chances of any continued attempts of graffiti. That's why we would love for you to report any graffiti you see around the city as quickly as possible. As someone who sees graffiti in the city, you have options to report it to us. One is our 24/7 graffiti hotline that you can call. We also have an email dedicated to graffiti removal. It's graffiti@fcgov.com. There's also Access Fort Collins. You can submit a request on that app. Unfortunately, graffiti is something many communities have to contend with. Thankfully, the City of Fort Collins has an efficient process to deal with these problems.
My name is James Reed, and I'm the Senior Manager of Operations here at the Streets Department. And part of my job is overseeing snow operations. The second the snow flies, my team is ready to fight the storm. During the winter months, we prioritize snow removal efforts to ensure passable roads and the safety for the traveling public. Our team focuses on three different types of priorities. Now, these priorities make up over 1,000 miles of snow removal efforts. Our priority ones consist of arterial streets, such as College, Horsetooth, or Harmony. These streets are considered the minimum network to keeping transportation systems open for our fire stations, hospitals, police stations, and rescue squads. Our goal is to have snow removed from our arterial roads within 4 hours after the snow has stopped falling. After our priority ones are cleared, we move to our priority twos and threes. These are the collector streets, such as Swallow, Stewart, or Remington. These streets allow major volume networks in and out of neighborhoods, access to bus routes, and schools. When it starts to snow, you might be wondering, where are the plows? They are typically focused on different levels of priorities. So they may not be in your neighborhood, but trust us, we are out there. So the City of Fort Collins has some of the most innovative and state-of-the-art technology that we depend on during each storm event. That information provides our command center and our crew chiefs the determination of level of grip, the temperature, pavement temperatures, wind direction, and a multitude of factors. We have what's called RWIS sites. An RWIS site means Road Weather Information Station. We have 12 of them located throughout the city that provides real-time information directly to our management team to ensure that we are making the most effective decision. So during the snow removal efforts, we have 24 trucks in our fleet where we're constantly fighting snow. Aiding in that effort are materials. Throughout the summer, we stockpile our salt barn that consists of over 10,000 tons of salt. We also have salt brine, which is actually manufactured here at the Streets Department. It is used for pre-storm, anti-icing, and during storm operations. This material supports our operators to clearing snow in a more effective and efficient manner. When applying any of these three materials, we focus on a fine balance of product usage to limit the chlorides throughout the snow removal process. It's not only street snow removal that we focus on. We have over 100 miles of protected bike lanes and sidewalks that require specific types of equipment to navigate through the tight areas. We focus on this after snow has been removed from our arterial roads. After a snowstorm, we evaluate roadways, bike lanes, sidewalks, and trails to ensure safe passage. We also rely on the community to bring up any safety concerns so we can evaluate those as well. That information can be provided to us via phone call, email, or Access 4 Collins.
The Healthy Homes program started back in 2011 with the goal of improving indoor air quality for community members within Fort Collins. And the program was largely educational in nature, and so we would go out and do assessments to identify 3 to 5 low-cost, no-cost recommendations people could implement in their home to improve their indoor air quality.
She'd probably want to keep down below 50.
I'm not exactly sure. That's a question I would ask my mom.
Pull out the insert and put it right in the mail.
And over time, as we were going into more and more homes, we recognized anecdotally that we were missing larger parts of our community, more specifically disproportionately affected communities in Fort Collins. And so we did an equity assessment a few years back to understand how we could improve our practices to include more community members, neighborhoods in Fort Collins. And so that really opened us up to the environmental justice space and understanding how we can better serve our community as a whole.
The Healthy Homes team received a grant from the EPA. It was a $200,000 grant to focus on environmental justice work within the community of Fort Collins, and specifically to update our Healthy Homes program with the idea of incorporating more energy efficiency into the program. And the vision of this work is that all Fort Collins community members have a healthy, energy efficient, and resilient home environment.
The changes that we've made as a part of this grant have really made that impact in terms of people feeling healthier in their homes. And those changes have specifically been HVAC servicing and cleaning, portable air cleaners, making sure people are well equipped in the event of a fire or carbon monoxide concerns, and doing some low-level weatherization. So while I love that we started off as an educational program, we really have been able to make huge strides to better serve our community members.